G'day guys, we're here today to talk about IRONMAN 4X4's brand new monotube shock absorber, the IM2.5. I'm Sean Spencer, the engineering manager here for the suspension team at IRONMAN, and together with a robust team, we're really excited to present this product to you. Today we'll be going over the features and benefits of this new product, the comparison between our existing twin tube shock absorber range. Now let's start with why monotube. IRONMAN 4X4 currently have three twin tubes in their range. However, their biggest strength is also their biggest limitation. And this specifically is to do with the piston size. Now here, I have a 45 series foam cell pro piston. And here, I have the brand new IM2.5 monotube piston. There's a 60% increase in surface area with the monotube piston when compared to the foam cell pro. The 60% increase in size enables us to really tune the vehicle for optimum ride comfort. In addition to the larger piston offering optimal ride comfort, there is also a significant weight saving between the two products. Somewhere between 3 to 3.5 times as much weight can be saved between the similar products. With some of the basics of the IM2.5 out of the way, let's deep dive into the product itself. First thing you'll notice is the IM2.5, which stands for 2.5 inches. Now, historically in monotube world, there's always a nomenclature to suggest it's 2, 2.5, 3 inches, something our American friends has given to us. Now, the main reason we stuck with 2.5 inches is actually to do with packaging. Now, the outer diameter of the IM2.5 product is very similar to the Foam Cell Pro. This means it's a seamless transition into many of the vehicles that we have in our applications list today. Another key feature of the IM2.5 is its aluminium construction. As I've already mentioned, the IM2.5 is made from aluminium. Now, while this offers significant weight reduction, it also offers superior heat dissipation when compared to its mild steel counterparts. So the monotube has two pistons, the rod piston and the IFP, or the internal floating piston. So let's start with the main piston. This is a CNC billeted aluminium piston. We've optimized the flow paths in here to really enhance the ride comfort. Additional porting for the bleeds to ensure that you've got that really lovely low speed control. To put it into context, let me show you where this resides inside the monotube shock absorber. Here it is on the end of the rod, housing the shims and the sintered Teflon band. Now that we've covered that, let's move on to a more unique feature of the monotube design, the IFP. Now the IFP is unique to the monotube shock absorber. Its purpose is to separate the oil and the high pressure nitrogen gas. The reason we're using high pressure nitrogen gas is to help prevent cavitation and extreme inputs into the vehicle. Now let's talk about the seal pack. This seal pack has been heavily engineered to ensure that it can withstand the harshest environments. The seal pack's been designed to withstand very high temperatures. Now why do you need high temperature resistance? Well, when you're smashing it down the canning stock route, your shock absorber is going to get extremely hot. The last thing you want is to have a failure through the seal. We have done extensive testing over the development years, and we can assure you that this seal pack is as rugged as it comes. Finishing off the shock absorber design, we have forged aluminium end caps. These are quite strong, robust. They also incorporate OEM equivalent bushes. Now we've done this on purpose to ensure that no matter where you are in Australia, you'll be able to find spare parts to suit your vehicle. Moving on to the dirt shield. Now we're very proud of this design, and it is often something that is overlooked when it comes to integrity and performance. We've spent hours ensuring that this thing has the proper drainage and also can live up to the harsh environments in the Australian outback and the world for that matter. Now, in addition to our monotube dampers, we also have monotube struts. Here is our IM2.5 strut, fully assembled straight out of the box. Here you can see the strut top, OEM. OEM design, meaning you can source it anywhere in the world for spare parts if you're stranded. Another key feature of the strut is its adjustability. Now every IM2.5 strut comes out of the box ready to tackle the bull bar, the winch, the burger with the lot, if you will. However, if you're not running all that equipment, you can simply wind the spring seat down to accommodate whatever load you have over the front axle. Having the ability to adjust this with a thread enables you to precisely find that optimum ride height. Now let's talk about some of the features that we chose not to incorporate into our first monotube. Now the first thing you'll notice is there's no remote reservoir. The reality is that a remote resi introduces complexity of fitment and longevity of the product, specifically leak points, which can occur between the hose, between the main body and the remote reservoir canister. Where IM2.5 don't have this, it means we offer a very capable, robust and a value for money solution. While we're talking value for money, another feature you may notice that we haven't included in our first IM2.5 is adjustability. Now, we feel strongly that we've spent countless hours and thousands of kilometers tuning these products to ensure that what comes out of the box is perfectly suitable for your vehicle. Another reason for that is 9 times out of 10 with adjustability, they go on the vehicle once and they're never touched again. So to maintain affordability, we left that feature out. Rest assured, there is no compromise to ride comfort and performance. So the ultimate question, which product is right for me? The IM2.5 or the Foam Cell Pro? Let's touch on some key features. The outer diameter of the IM2.5, as the name suggests, is 2.5 inches. The Foam Cell Pro, slightly larger at 2.6 to 2.9 inches. The benefit of these large bodies is the oil volume. The more oil you have in here, the longer it takes to heat up. In addition, the larger body promotes a quicker and easier heat dissipation. Moving into the pistons. Now, even though they are similar in size, it does not mean they're similar on the inside. As we spoke about earlier, the Foam Cell Pro has a 45 millimeter OD piston, where the Monotube offers a 57 millimeter OD piston. Now, why is that beneficial to have a larger piston? It enables us to really hone in on that optimum ride comfort and pure ride control. So let's move on to construction. Both of these products have a 3 millimeter wall, with the Foam Cell Pro being in mild steel and the IM2.5 being in aluminium. We've already briefly touched on the benefits of aluminium over mild steel, but effectively the biggest one is going to be the weight saving. We're talking almost 3 kilos per corner. With the weight saving comes a common question about the actual construction, or the internals, if you will, of these products. A feature of the twin tube, as the name suggests, is its twin walled construction. This thing can take rocks, it can just take the harshest sort of environments and still operate, even with the body on the outside damaged. So on to durability. As the name suggests with the twin tube, it has an outer layer that protects it from damage and maintains its operation from severe stone strikes. To get around this in the rear with the IM2.5, we've made a rod down so the internals are protected up high in the vehicle, while the shaft and the seals are protected by our robust dirt shield. Foam Cell Pro, think military, think indestructible. When it comes to IM2.5, think the ultimate ride comfort. So for the final chapter of today, we're going to talk a little bit more about the tuning differences between the IM2.5 and the Foam Cell Pro. The Foam Cell product is designed with the tourer in mind. Those of our customers that are heading out there with heavily laden vehicles traveling over thousands of kilometers of really rough terrain. This is both in Australia and worldwide. This product had to be robust, safely accommodate heavy loads, and be tuned for control. All of these parameters are perfectly suited to a twin tube digressively valved product. The valving characteristics focus on low speed control, which really minimizes the body roll. We're talking heavily laden vehicle, long sweeping corners. Conversely, the IM2.5, we've capitalized on that big piston design, bringing that lovely linear characteristic, which really provides that soft, plush ride that our customers are looking for. In summary, both Foam Cell Pro and IM2.5 are designed for both on and off-road use. The Foam Cell Pro lends itself to a stiffer, more controlled product with unmatched durability, with the IM2.5 tuned to soak up the bumps both on and off-road for that plush ride experience. That about wraps it up for the IM2.5 introduction. Any questions, please reach out to your local Ironman store or jump on our website. Thanks very much.